Welcome back to The Late Swing, our special T20 sports show. Tonight, our three sports fans are Khwaja Ubaid, who usually changes his batting stance at least four times during an innings, Sherry Malik, who believes only people with his initials should be named Pakistan captains, and Mohsin Ghiwala, who once went into hibernation for about 3 days after he played a false shot to a 10-year-old. Gentlemen, welcome. What an amazing game. Pakistan weren't favorites, Sri Lanka were the favorite teams, and Pakistan did the job. Khwaja Ubaid, what do you think?
Absolutely brilliant performance by Pakistan. It restored the faith that a lot of people had lost in the Pakistan team of making it to the next stage. But Shoaib Malik led from the front and did a brilliant job. And we have a great chance to get to the second round now.
Sherry Malik, Tony Gregg, all the analysts were saying, hey, Pakistan has no chance against Sri Lanka. Even a couple of vessels the other day on our show said that, you know, Sri Lanka is one of the favorites for the tournament. So how did Pakistan do it?
Shoaib Malik, take a bow. Talk about leading from the front. And I loved his comment during the presentation where he said that, you know, it was 33 for 3 and I said, I'm just going to be positive. I think it was just fantastic leadership. He took the game by the scruff of the neck and just made sure that Pakistan wins. I think Shoaib Malik's contribution is probably did it. I think he should have been man of the match. But anyway, I think fantastic leadership and I'm very glad that we have a positive captain in Shoaib Malik.
Mohsin Ghiwala.
Very risky for me to sit in this seat after a Pakistan match, you know. It's I don't know how to feel, but today I'm ecstatic. It's brilliant. What I really enjoyed was the way Shoaib Malik and Yunus Khan handled Malinga and Jayasurya. Amazing batting performance from Pakistan. I mean, it was professional. Professional to the core. Not really happy with the opening, but you can't blame Pakistan for such a good
Well, let's just have a quick look at the match summary. I mean, Pakistan lost the toss, but it's probably, I think Shoaib Malik said that he would have batted first anyway. Pakistan scored 189 and 9.4 runs and over, literally 33 for 3 in like the sixth over. And then Sri Lanka batted 156 all out. Shahid Afridi, once again, the man of the moment for Pakistan, taking 3 for 18 in 4 overs. But let's just go back to the first innings, Khwaja. I mean, Pakistan's performance, Yunus Khan, Shoaib Malik, you know, 189, was it good enough, do you think?
I think it was as good a score as that you could expect from Pakistan against Sri Lanka. As Sherry said, not only did Shoaib and Yunus stem the rot that had set in after the openers and first down had gone, they counter-attacked, which was brilliant. I mean, for them to have the confidence to counter-attack and build such a brilliant score. I mean, I think 170 would have been a competitive score here. To take it to 189, with some great hitting by Misbah at the end, gave us a really good chance of winning this game.
But you know, once again, I mean, the biggest issue, guys, is like the top order. Once again, a 33 for 3, Salman Butt, Imran Nazir, Mohammad Hafeez, all back in the hut. You know, the senior players, you know, they should start the innings. Your best players should bat first, right?
And that's a problem that Pakistan faces at this moment in time. Now, who else do you open with? You have Salman Butt, you have Imran Nazir, you have Mohammad Hafeez. And who do you have in the banks? You have got Fawad Alam, Rauf Iftikhar, Abdul Rahman. So right now, I don't see any other options rather than just playing this ball.
What about Shoaib Malik? Opening with Kamran Akmal, maybe?
I really don't know about that, but I think Pakistan needs a change. If Shoaib Malik is playing well, he should bat up front. Misbah is batting too low. He's in form. Misbah should probably get a chance higher up the order. I think Pakistan's best players need to bat up front. The argument is, why wasn't Shoaib Malik, you know, batting higher than his position today at number 5?
But you have Salman Butt as a specific role in this team. You know, Shoaib Malik has said that he's out there to take the shine off the ball. It's really anti-2020 cricket, but that's what he's doing. And he's literally trying to play. So that's what he was doing today as well, trying to take the shine off the ball. I mean, even though he got a bad shot.
Let me interrupt you there for a second. Let's just look at the analysis of the match in terms of the boundaries and the extras. If we just have a quick look at that, I mean, literally Pakistan hit more or less the same boundaries as Sri Lanka did, and they gave away more extras. Pakistan gave away 16 extras, but 12 fours were hit, 8 sixes, and the majority of the sixes came from Shoaib Malik and Yunus Khan.
Yeah, Pakistan's boundaries came when they were counter-attacking. I think Sri Lanka's most of those boundaries you see came when the game was pretty much lost.
Dilshan
and Chamara Silva, by the time they got going, I think the match had pretty much got away from them.
A very important point. Did you see the way Yunus and Shoaib did the running? When they were getting the sixes, they were getting a lot of twos in between. Pakistan made sure that there were not a lot of dot balls. Okay, if there was a six in the over, they would make that over count by taking a lot of twos and singles. Sri Lanka never got any momentum in their innings. If there was a six or a four, then, you know, they weren't getting, there were a lot of dot balls in between. And
what I liked about Pakistan's batting with Shoaib Malik and Yunus Khan, the way they handled Jayasurya and Malinga. Now, they had a specific strategy. They were walking on the leg side and smashing the straight balls down straight or over mid-wicket. And that was a specific strategy which Yunus Khan followed, Shoaib Malik followed, and Misbah Ul-Haq followed in the end. Jayasurya is a very good bowler in these kind of conditions, bowling flat out, bowling low. They stepped on the leg side, give themselves a room.
Just a quick term, but Misbah Ul-Haq, he came a little, once again, Kamran Akmal promoted above him. This guy just helped you nearly win a match against India. He came down at number eight. I mean, don't you think that's a joke?
Misbah takes time to kick off. He takes his time.
Strategy that worked. I mean, he scored, what, 16 in six balls. Mm-hmm. And it's something that worked for you. I mean, one position up here and he might get four, five more balls. But the point is, everyone who came after Yunus and Shoaib scored more than run a ball. So everyone did their little bit. You know, they never let the run rate fall behind once we got the momentum going.
Kamran is supposed to be more aggressive. Kamran is supposed to be more aggressive than
Let's just change gears very simply, Sherry. Let's talk about the Sri Lankan innings. Now, bowling. Sohail Tanveer opening the bowling. Come on, you're thinking he's bowling to Jayasurya. He's just dropped the catch. What were you going through when you saw him coming into bowl?
Well, to be honest, when I first thought, I said, you know, what is Sri doing? I mean, the guys just dropped a catch and I was fearing the worst. But what a masterstroke to, you know, have the confidence to give the guy the ball even after he's just dropped a catch. Hats off to Shoaib Malik. And my God, it was the most exciting part of the day.
But you dropped lots of catches on the field like I have. I mean, like, you know, when you drop a catch and suddenly you've been told to bowl. Right. I mean, what goes through your mind?
I think it's for a young guy to come in and he's been told just, you know, go there and do his best. Brilliant ball first up. But even before Shoaib Malik putting him to bowl in the second over, you know, you'd think when Shoaib Akhtar went home and you heard who was coming in his place, the question that came into your mind was, Suhail who?
Right. I mean, anyway, guys, we have to go to a quick break, but we have a lot more to talk about. Especially Pakistan and the big game tomorrow against Australia. So don't go anywhere.